I got one son that goes to a public school, and little brother goes to a private school. It's an experiment. I just want to see what's going to happen to him. But what's weird is my little son in private school, he's like my thuggy son, you know what I mean? I don't know where he get that from. He's not getting it from me. And he's definitely not getting it from that school. That school is very, like, it's a liberal school. It's the kind of school, there might be like 12 black students in the entire school. And I'm the only black parent. And none of the parents like me either. Not because I'm black, but just like they don't like how I roll. Because I be showing up late all the time, and I'm like in a Porsche and I'm blasting music that they don't like. You know, the music be like, I beat the pussy up, and I pull into the parking lot. I might be smoking a cigarette with the kids in the car. Then I pull into like that handicap space. And then when I get out of the handicap space, they always want to say some passive aggressive shit. Morning, Dave. Don't know if you noticed, but you actually parked in the handicap space. Huh? Yeah, you know what, Frank? I did notice. But who is this handicapped guy we're all waiting on that never shows up? So I hate going over to that school. The only parents that are nice to me is a lesbian couple, Kate and Sarah. Actually, Kate hates my guts. Sarah knows that I'm black, and she's half black, so she just understands me. You know what I'm saying? I can't explain it. Because I'll say shit, and Kate's just too serious about being a lesbian. I'll be like, hey, Kate. Hey, Sarah. You guys going to the father-son picnic next week? How's that going to work? And Kate will instantly be furious. But Sarah knows I'm fucking around, so she'll just say something cool. I don't know, Dave. Maybe me and Kate will flip for that shit. I said, bitch, you better save that coin toss because everybody knows you're strapping on to that household. And then Kate will turn bright red, but Sarah just fist bumped me like, you right, nigga, it's me. We're good friends. We're good friends. They invite me to stuff. They're like my only friends at the school. So imagine my surprise when I go to pick my son up after all this happens. And the teacher is waiting outside for me. She's just standing right there in the middle of the fucking handicap space. I knew something was wrong, so I rolled the window. We talked to you for a minute in the office. I said, no, fuck that. We got to talk right here. What's going on? I knew it was bad. Ibrahim had a fight. I said, a fight? Don't worry. Everyone's okay. I said, everyone? What happened? Well, that's it. We don't know what happened because he won't talk to anybody. All we know is that he punched Sarah Jr. in the face. I said, oh, no. Sarah's one of the only parents I'm not sure I can beat up in this school. Just then, Kate and Sarah pulled up to pick up their daughter. And then we all had to go into the office. And I was really worried because I didn't want them to kick me out of the school. And then they brought my son in. He was crying. They brought him in like a prisoner. He was like, oh. I said, son, just stop crying, calm down. Do not look at these mean faces. I need you to look at my face, and I need you to tell me the truth, buddy, all right? Just tell me the truth. Is it true? Did you punch that girl, Sarah Jr., in the face? I was trying to give him a signal to lie, but he didn't pick up on it. I was like... He wasn't paying attention. She said, yes, Daddy, I punched her face. I said, oh, my God. Why? Why would you do that? You're not supposed to put your hand. So gangster, it scared all the parents in the room. He was like, because she had it coming. I said, oh. And everyone looked at me. I said, I did not teach you. I don't know where he got that from. I said, what does that mean, son? That is crazy talk. What does that mean? And then he just started crying like he was Tupac. Oh. These kids keep fucking with me. I told his teacher, I said, well, now wait a minute. This kid is a lot of things, but he's not a liar. And if he said they was fucking with him, they did something to him. Son, what's going on? What did they do to you? Oh, Dad, I'm tired of this shit. It's been going on all week. I said, what's going on all week? He said, we said, Hutch and that bitch bit my sandwich. I said, oh. said, it's the fourth time this week. I'm tired of this sandwich biting bitch. I said, stop using that word. Let's go home. That's a quiet car ride home. We got to the house, he just ran right up to his room, slammed the door. His mother came downstairs. By then, she had heard about everything. She was looking at me like, oh my. She said, you bit that goddamn sandwich, didn't you, Daddy? I said, I'm tired of you accusing me of shit. And I just ran out of the house, jumped in my car and drove off. Of course I bit that sandwich.
See, I'm gonna tell you something. My daughter, 22 years old. She's away from home for 5 years. Ain't nobody been in the house but me and my wife. 25 years, man. Beautiful thing. I ain't sending for no applause. I'm trying to tell you a story. Me and my wife been in the house walking around naked eating and everything. Shit get broke, I know who the fuck did it, you know. Now I got 3 new people in my damn house. I got my sister. See, we family. No, can I? We family. Can I? I'm gonna talk to you. We family. I got my sister's children living with me now. I'm about to go crazy like a motherfucker around here, you know? See, my sister on drugs. I ain't ashamed to tell you. Some of your family members fucked up too around here. I ain't ashamed to tell you. But my brother called me, North Carolina. My brother said, he said, Mac, you gotta come home, man. The court gonna separate the kids. I said, no, you know, I can't have that. I can't have that. I said, I'm gonna be there. Now, mind y'all, North Carolina, I know them, but I don't know them. You know what I'm talking about? I know the kids, but I don't know these motherfuckers, you know? 2, 4, and 6. Ooh, shit, come help me babysit these motherfuckers. I get there, I'm in court. The judge said, the Mac family, I stood up. I said, yes, Your Honor. I'm part of the Mac family. He said, we're gonna separate the kids. I said, Your Honor, you mean separate like divide? He said, very good, Mr. Mac, very good. I said, you know what? I said, Your Honor, I can't allow that. I said, my brother and I, we're gonna split custody. That motherfucker turned his back on me, like he didn't say shit. Yeah, punk some of a bitch. See, you know, Cain killed Abel, you know what I mean? I said, Your Honor, I'm gonna take the kid for 6 months, and my brother gonna take the kid for 6 months. This punk son of a bitch, get up and walk the fuck out. I ain't seen him since. If I ever seen him, I'm fucking him up on sight. I'm gonna bust his head to the white meat. I'll slap all over. Y'all gonna read about it. Whenever I see this motherfucker, gonna be a misunderstanding. There's gonna be some furniture moving around this motherfucker. I said, Your Honor, I take the kid. Now I got these 3, some of my bitch. Excuse my French. That's what I want to say, you know. These motherfuckers on my goddamn nerve. Y'all got to pray for me. And that 2-year-old, she the motherfucker. She the ringleader. This never been here before. She a shepherd for the devil. She worked for the devil. And the 4-year-old, my sister was really getting high with her because she don't talk. She don't say shit. All she do is look at your ass like this here. I told her ass the other day, I said, let me tell you something. If a fire break out, you better have a whistle or a horn or something. Cause you're gonna be a burner motherfucker fucking with me. I ain't got time for no deaf mute. Talk! Holler! No, tell that lid. Then the 6-year-old, he a homosexual. No, I ain't gonna need you on. No 6-year-old walk all like this here. Crying all the goddamn time. Quit crying, just a push-up or something. I came in the house the other day, man, at 1:30 in the morning. The 2-year-old gonna send the faggot downstairs for some milk and cookies. I'm going upstairs, he coming down. He gonna walk past me like I'm a visitor. I said, where you going? He said, to get some milk and cookies. He said it so funny, I wanted to hear it again. I said, get some what? He says, some milk and cookies. I love the motherfucker, but he's a faggot, you know. I told him, I said, man, it's too goddamn late for some damn cookies and milk, man. Take your punk ass upstairs and get some rest. That's how I talk to him. Fuck that timeout shit. I ain't got time for these badass kids. These kids will kill you. They gonna kill me. I'm gonna kill them. I can see y'all reading Jet and Ebony right now. He's talking. It's a shame how Bernie fucked up those damn kids. I can't get no rest. They walk around the house 3-4 o'clock in the morning. Got their finger under my nose, seeing if I'm breathing, all that kind of shit. Badass, some of my bitches. Rocking all the goddamn time. I ain't no psychologist. Then this dumb man gonna sit up there, she gonna go upstairs. The 2-year-old, I heard the 2-year-old say, "Where the cookies and shit?" He gonna tell her, "Him downstairs." Who the fuck is him? Like I ain't got no name or something. "Him downstairs." The 2-year-old said, "Well, I go get this shit myself." She gonna walk her little bow-legged head down there. I'm standing in the corner. I watch her get a little step ladder. She gonna go on open the refrigerator. I said, "What the fuck you doing?" She looked at me, "I'm gonna get some milk and cook." I said, "Didn't I tell your punk ass boy he couldn't have no goddamn cook? Are you listening when I tell the faggot he couldn't have no? Now I'm telling your short ass he can't have no goddamn milk cookies. Get your punk ass upstairs before you get fucked up around here. Or she gonna look at me like I'm short, you know." No, North Carolina. Everybody in this room know what that look mean. That look mean you wanna do something to me. So I backed up. And I told her, bust a move. Bust a motherfucking move.